to run into.
I know that the movie's good, you know, I made the darn thing, and I ain't even a question at the end, it's just, you know, I know it's a work of genius sometimes, you know, people, it takes you 10, 15, 20 years before people recognize the genius of your work, you know, and I don't got that much time, you know, I need it now, you know, it's just a matter of, you know, this audience here, will they recognize, you know, that I'm the fucking man.
Everything going okay, Jim?
Dude, I'm just... You rub my shoulders a little
bit. You got this, man. You got this. Really glad to have you here. It's going to be a great show. You know, it's a little past six, so, yeah, you know, just, you know, rest up.
I'm not nervous at all, dude.
That's good. That's good. It's going to be a great turnout. We're going to, you know, I'm expecting, you know, a couple hundred people. So, yeah, but don't let that get to you. Rest up. Get your head in the mind space that you need it to be, and, we look forward to having you out there, buddy. All right, we'll see you on the other side. Next, we have a filmmaker who I'm a big fan of. I believe this is his debut film. It's called How Do You Know Me? The legendary Jim Duffy, you know, he has
local celebrity. Really big deal.
He hasn't been around very long, but he's really made a name for himself in this amount of time. So, without further ado, let's watch How Do You Know Me?
Thank you for what I've done, you know. And the Fred Wards, you know, I just wanted to make a movie that I thought Fred Ward would be proud of, you know? Love Fredmers.
I think Fred Ward would be damn proud of this film.
Thank you, dude. If he's out there, you know, hook me up.
Now, I saw in the credits you work a lot with family. So what's that like? I know that the you know, family dynamics can,
you know. You work with what you can get, you know? You call up your cousin, you call up your brother, I'm making an action movie. What do you think?
Okay.
And they're like, word. They show up and do it. Bam.
So, was I correct earlier? This is your first feature?
First movie.
This is your first, all right.
Heck yeah.
And, yeah, well, how long, what do you shoot on?
I don't shoot on nothing but high 8, dude. I love the high 8 look, you know, that green home video type look, you know, man, you can take your HP and, you know, go ahead.
So that's a very cultivated look. You are shooting for that gritty style.
Absolutely. Greater the better.
So, what was the most difficult scene to shoot in this movie?
Heck, if I had to guess, it'd be all of them, you know? But probably the pool scene, you know, that opens up the film. That was pretty difficult, because a lot of those guys, I don't know if you couldn't tell, they weren't actually there. They were green screened that much. So, I thought we did a pretty good job with
that. Yeah, you know, I question the black line for a second, but I feel like it weaves pretty seamlessly. Yeah, exactly. It looks good. Especially with your limited resources.
Thanks, man. I appreciate that.
What was your budget like on this?
After beer and cigarettes, like $50.
You did pretty good for $50.
I had the camera, so, you know, I could add that in there, but I had it, so that's kind of cheap, you know. If I tell people it's, you know, $200.
That's fair.
So, tell us about these ducks.
Those are my brother Slim's ducks. He really likes ducks, you know. If you know anything about my brother, you know. I tell him we should get a couple of geese, but he's against it. He just loves his ducks, you know. Those are his guard ducks. Some people love guard dogs. He has guard ducks.
All right.
they seem to be doing a really good job guarding.
No, you know, I got through pretty easily, so I might have to disagree with you on that.
I noticed that you take advantage of some pretty interesting locations. You had a basement, for instance. What appeared to be maybe a barn or something. How do you go about your location scouting?
Well, I know a couple of guys. I know a farmer named Rusty out in Biddeford there. He's got a nice old farm, and that was Slim's house.
Okay.
The green door, yellow shutters.
Going back to working with what you had.
Yeah, and then we shot in my shed, which is where I live next door.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you, Jim. Does anybody out there in the audience have any questions? Yes.
Will there be a sequel?
I think that's the question we've all been wondering.
There may or may not be a Happy Mummy 2, but there is another movie online there called Brutal Mountain Outlaws. You can go check that out. That's similar, you know, action, fights,
it's
guns
got,
and stuff.
It's got the Jim Duffy flavor, is
absolutely.
What you're saying.
But how do you know me too? I don't know, you know, I mean, I kind of shot myself at the end, so maybe I'm a zombie. I'm a cool.
That could really work. The horror fan base is pretty large out there, so, you know. You know, and there's a lot of action and horror complicated crossover, so. Yes, Eric.
The visual effects, which were outstanding, especially the burning flames and the gunshots and stuff. How did you do those?
Man, I just download them off the internet. I don't know if that's illegal or whatever, but hey, don't put them up there if you don't want them taken, you know?
That's fairly wise.
Some people take my movie, but I guess it's kind of karma. They do make a whole bunch of money off it.
Anybody else? Any other questions?
How long did it take you to film the
About a day and a half. It was brutal.
Did you, was it you, the three of you, Slim, and Tyler together the whole time? Or
a lot of creative differences, let me tell you what. Actually, me and my cousin Tyler, you know, me and him have been going at it since we were little whippersnappers.
Yeah, I've met Tyler. He's a little edgy.
He's intense, dude. But, you know, he only wants to do these kind of movies, so I gotta keep making them. If I want anybody to be in my movie, I gotta go, okay, I'll make another action movie.
Alright.
I don't want to do nothing else.
That's great, Jim. Yeah, we really love your film. Maybe we can get you to show, what was the name of your other film?
Brutal Mountain Outlaws.
Perhaps maybe the next Midco Cinema Lounge, we could get you enter that for the next one.
That'd be cool, you know?
Yeah.
I tried once and the sound didn't work.
Yeah, I know, Jim.
That was that Amy girl.
I apologize.
Yeah, she's not coming back.
Don't
worry about her.
Here, can we find you on the internet?
Absolutely.
I see a hint. Let finish up your. Where can we find you on the internet?
Well, you know, you go to. My brother's got a show there, Slim. It's called the Slim Duffy Show. I don't really agree with it personally, but they pay me to be in it, so I'm in it for the money. But if you go to youtube.com/theSlimDuffyShow or the Facebook Slim Duffy Show, you can find it on there. But you know, I only go for the money. I don't appreciate how they treat them.
And we've got another question right over here.
Yeah, that last gun, the one that you ended up shooting the guy with and shooting the head up. That looked like a Civil War era.
I keep it old school. The gun terrifies people, man. I'll tell you what, they don't know how big of a bang. It looks like a little, you know, pop gun, but man, if you don't want to hear that go off, the things, those little things you put in your ears and the shoot.
Ear plugs?
Yeah.
Great. Anybody else? This is our last one of the evening, folks. So if there's questions, now's the time. All right. Jim, do you have anything else you'd like to add before we wrap up?
Free Quebec.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you. All right. To the rest of you, we really appreciate you coming out tonight. This is, you know, our second Midco Cinema Lounge. We are striving to make this a regular thing. Constantly looking for some more submissions and looking to keep a nice variety of films to show so that it touches everyone in some capacity. So, thank you again for coming. Stay on the lookout for more Midco Cinema stuff.
Thank you everyone so much. Please come back.
Thank you.
You're a fucking star.